Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Console Warriors, where we'll play anything. Alex here, ready to dive back into Paper Mario, The Thousand Year Door. Just wanted to show off the title screen, because now Goombella's on there. I think they'll be, as partners join us, it'll start looking a little bit closer to how the title screen did in the original, plus a couple extras. But where we last left off, we just reached the first chapter of Petal Meadows. Gonna get started right here. Oh, wow. Oh, okay, they have the extra animations and reactions. Like, the game is now so much more expressive and alive. It's just really amazing. Whoa, what was that? I've never seen anything that humongous before. It looked kind of scary, too. It definitely flew into that castle back there, right? Let's get going in case it comes back. Here we go. Again. Oh, yes. Here we are, Petal Meadows. This rock kind of reminds me of a pipe. Yep. Alright. Hey, got a mushroom. Like how, the items now just kind of drop right below. Before they would, like, bounce around to the side and such. But we're beginning our adventure. Oh, come here. I did check out a little bit more of the game. Not much further. I just wanted to kind of get a feel for the battles and such. But one thing I noticed... some people were saying online that they actually reused the Origami King engine to build this remake, and yeah, I can see that happening. It just kind of nearly messed up the timing there. Yeah, there's something I can really believe that they built it right off the Origami King's engine, besides just making everything look really pretty. Yes. But, oh, Dizzy Dial. That's nice. Nope. how's everybody doing today? Like I said, I've been waiting all day to just come back from work and make some more videos. Because this game is my comfort food. Oof. I've been waiting and waiting and waiting so long, and now I don't want to wait anymore. I just want to experience all the goodness and just share that with you guys. Like, the majesty of this game. I'm just so glad that it's more widely available. I was one of those lucky souls who had, you know, my copy. It was still the GameCube game. Alright, I don't need to go up there right now. Oh, here's a little secret for you. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In the original, it would, like, go down, but here, they blink, and that bothers me. Wiggles. Oh, here we go. Oh, one more thing, Mario. Okay, wondering what to do. Just play it for a hint. Alright, well, I doubt I'll need it too much. Maybe once. I'll try it out a couple times, but I pretty much know what I'm doing, except for, you know, some secrets. Because, yeah, even though I've played this game to death, even I haven't gone for all the secrets. Mainly, like, the all the star pieces. I know where enough are to get pretty much what I want from Dazzle, but I might actually just go for them all, if not here on the for the series, then definitely on my own time for that new concept art and gallery and such. Oh, yeah, see, normally in the original game, you would press up, like a little exclamation point would show up, and then you would, like, shake the bush. Now, you gotta whack it with your hammer. Which is a lot like Origami King and Color Splash, with how you interact with the environment. Yeah, see, you know, you would shake and they would part ways, but here instead you just knock it over by giving it a good old whack of the hammer. But here we go, hopping into the background. Ugh, This game's just so pretty. I meant to do that. Totally meant to do that. Because there's a star piece! I'll probably have to, like, look up a list at some point. So maybe I'll get some of the backtracking ones once I get, like, some abilities later and get those off screen, maybe. I don't know. I figured it'd be tedious to watch me backtrack a bunch. Yeah. And if the battles ever get, like, too boring or something to watch, then I'll probably, like, cut those out and just kind of show the main quest. Oop. Fire flower! Yay! Alright. That does it for that part. Oh, Petalburg. Oh. Oh, this is nice. Welcome, travelers! Where are you, you ask? Why, this is Petalburg. Sorry, but it's been a long time since we've had visitors here. Yepity, once that dragon Hooktail was spotted flying around this area. Well, it didn't help tourism, put it that way. People just stopped visiting. Dragon? Hooktail? That must have been that huge thing we saw earlier, Mario. So, it's called Hooktail, huh? Ooh, scary name. By the way, Green Boots, have you ever heard of these things called Crystal Stars? We're on this quest for them. It's very important. Crystal Stars, you say? Nope, can't say that I have. Sorry about that. You may want to speak with the mayor, though. He's old. Really, really old. As such, he knows all kinds of stuff. Koopas of his age are, really smart. Anyway, the mayor lives in that pink house up ahead. A pink house? Sounds totally hideous, but it should be easy to find. Thanks for your help. Oh, I like how, like, even, like, the bleeps and bloops of the dialogue are, like, all character and species specific. Classic Goomba Koopa Troopa noises. And chompers. So I've... Oh, Mario's attired. Yeah, I learned that you can stop you now, but if you keep pressing, you will fall in there. And you can still jump in there. Oh, Hooktail? She lives at the top of that old castle beyond this hummock and petal meadows. Have you heard the rumors? Some say lots of treasure is hidden in that castle. Scores of people have gone in search of it, but not a one has returned. So, what do you think? You're getting scared, huh? I like how the villagers now specifically refer to Hooktail as a she. Because you only learn that it's a female dragon until, like, way late in the game. Hey, what's up? I gotta say, I've been playing a lot of GBA games lately. There's this one that just absolutely rules. It's called Fire Emblem. You can play it now on NSO. With an expansion pass. You ever heard of it? Man, it rocks my socks. Yep, Intelligent Systems also made Fire Emblem. Ew! What's with this guy, huh? It grosses me out just being near this weirdo. Alright, fine, whatever. His name is Dupree. He's this icky guy who tries to sweet-talk everybody. They are no more. Oh, bonjour, mademoiselle. Isn't it a beautiful day? No, no, no. Not you, Monsieur de la Moustache. I am speaking to the lovely little cabbage behind you, mon petit chat. Did you hear me, beautiful? Abandon this dullard and come away with me. Ew. Are you kidding? Ew. Nice wig, you disco wannabe. Take a hike, bozo the chump. Oh. Jesus bless. I can't speak. I can't do French. I am wounded. Such brutal honesty. Such a sharp tongue. I shall retreat for now. If you change your mind, come find me. What a total sleaze. Let's go somewhere else, Mario. Oh, young lady, you could not forget me after all, is that it? Right, such burning persistence. This is why I adore you. Ah, my love, mon amour. When my mind turns to you, I feel the moss of love flutter in my belly button. That's the worst line I've ever heard. Mario, let's ditch this loser already.
Okay, just wanted to get the dialogue. We'll be seeing him a few times.
Oh, you. That's General White the Babomb. I guess White Babombs are pretty rare. He has such a cool mustache, too. He might even give your lip fuzz a run for its money. What? I am General White. I am a Ba-bomb. And I have lost my hopes and dreams. Ugh, that's a mood. I live in solitude always. I must apologize by ask that you leave me alone. Oh, poor guy. Wait, hold on. Oh my gosh. Yes. Yes! It's even better than Origami King where you crumple people. Oh, I can abuse children! Yes. Yes. Child abuse. Huh. I think they changed the prices in here. Yeah, I'll take one of those. Alright. Pop a save. Oops. Didn't mean to do it again. Silly Mario. Such a silly boy. Oh. Hey, guy. So you got pics of my not-girlfriend. This guy's apparently a total diehard Peach fan. He even collects Peach merchandise. He has posters and merch displayed everywhere. Boy, kid alive, know what I mean? Hey, Mario. Don't tell me you have a secret collection of plush Peach dolls, too. Hey, keep your hands to yourself here. Basically everything in this room is a one-of-a-kind collectible. I think he said something different in the original. It's pretty interesting. Boy, the mayor has been forgetful lately. I'm actually worried since the old guy forgets my name from time to time. These are the Traveling Sisters 3. They seem to go everywhere together. They also seem inattentive. Do they even notice each new place they wind up in? What, like the Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants or something? Hey, 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 it's us, the Happy Wanderers, the Traveling Sisters 3. This village is famous for its clear air, clean water, and one more thing. That big bad hooktail, we can't wait to see her. That's cool.
Toad abuse.
Oh, okay. Laid back and happy, okay. Talk about unique personalities. Very individualistic, to put it nicely. Or not so nicely, downright kooky.
Hey, Toad. Toad.
That's a Toad from Petalburg. He just seems like a regular Toad to me. But I hear he leads a secret life as president of the Luigi fan club. Hey. Hey, can I join? I love Luigi. He's my brother. And I love him. He's great. He's so brave. I hear there's a scary kind of monster that lives near town. Normal attacks are completely useless against it. Oh, and that's not all. Fire attacks are also useless. The very idea freaks me out. What can I do if one attacks me? I wonder if the shop has a way for me to throw money at the problem. Oh, hey. A subtle pointing. They did not do that in the original. Not through an NPC dialogue, anyway. Now, let's see what's in here. Oh, nice little picture of the beanpole, Hooktail Castle. Oh, now this little area has a purpose! That's Coop's dad! It's like a little shrine to him. Because I would always go up here and there was no point to it. Now there is. Neat. That's Coops from Petalburg. He's got confidence issues. He's a cringer, you know? What does that mean, Goombella? I never quite caught that. But this dude is just me. But he's definitely got a serious interest in Hooktail. I wonder why. Oh, I forgot to talk to him! How rude of me to wander into your house and not say anything. Hi there, folks. Did you come to this village to look for the treasure of Hooktail Castle? Well, that Hooktail is one tough cookie. Well, hello there. My name is Koopy-Koo. It's nice to meet you. Oh my gosh, that hat, those overalls, and that magnificent stash. You're Mario, aren't you? Oh yeah. I've heard tales of how strong you are. If you're here, that means you're going to challenge that monstrous Hooktail. Oh, if only Koops were as brave as you. My boyfriend Koops is just sort of, well, wishy-washy. He's not quite timid, but... Well, I guess I just wish he would be more, you know, manly sometimes. Oh, Koops, why did I have to fall for someone like him? Wait, was that out loud? Don't you dare tell him I said I've fallen for him. Please, I beg of you. Why? Why would you not want to tell him?
Oh, okay, I didn't mean to do that.
Yeah, you can't just, like, shake these bushes anymore. You gotta hammer them. So weird. But the mayor's house is as pink as I remember it. I like that you can see the extra detail on the pictures now. It's a really nice attention to detail. That's Croup, the mayor of Petalburg. He just babbles whether he's alone or not. I know someone like this. I just can't tell if he's really senile or he's just working that angle, you know? Working the angle.
What's that? Someone there? Who is it? Who? What do you want from me? I know. You're thieves! Here to rob a defenseless old Koopa. Despicable. Go on, do what you will. But as you can plainly see, there's nothing to steal here. Oh, I guess I have a little money. Take it, you fiends. And my antique shell, too.
Just leave the photos of me and the missus. Can't do without those memories.
What? Not thieves, you say? Well, what's your story, then? Oh, wait, you folks looking for crystal stars? Well, why didn't you pipe up before, you idiot? We're just wasting time here.
The crystal stars, you say you're hunting?
Wait, what did I hear about those dang things again? Aha, got it. Hooktail. Hooktail's got what you're looking for. She's this enormous ornery dragon. Eats folks, they say. You know Hooktail, right?
Of course.
Well, this Hooktail's brutal flyby snackings have all of us on pins and needles. So, are you reckless fools? I mean, are you gallant heroes off to rough her up?
You got it.
Oh, sounds promising. Why, if you can rid us of Hooktail, we'll shower you with gratitude and rewards. Wait, what's that I hear? You'll accept no reward?
I didn't say that.
What an unselfish man. You're noble indeed. Yep, a good egg. Now, what did you say your name was again?
I'm a Mario.
Murphy, huh? Well, it's a fine name, yes, a fine name indeed. Well now, Murphy, it's Mario. I appreciate that, Murphy. They are nice eyebrows. Now listen up. If you're intent on going to Hooktail Castle, find the secret pipe that's located somewhere in Petal Meadows. I know you need the Sunstone and the Moonstone to use that pipe. The stones are somewhere in Schwonk Fortress, just past the village. Get them first. Well then, Murphy, get going and really wallop that Hooktail monster. Alright. I think we've got everything we need, so we can just go right on ahead. Huh. I didn't get stopped for, the email thing. The little gadget. Normally you get stopped by that in the original. Some stone monsters live at Schwonk Fortress up ahead. Or so we fear. This gate's here to keep them out. But if the mayor says it's okay, I'll let you pass. Careful out there, though. Excuse me. I beg your pardon. Wait a moment, please. Hey, buddy. Pardon me for yelling like that. I was panicking. How to begin? My name's Koops. I heard you're traveling to Hooktail's Castle. I have a favor to ask. Oh, just forget it. Never mind. Ignore me. Goodbye. Okay. That was weird. What do you think was going on inside that guy's shell?
Slight script change.
I'm not talking to you. Hey, since you're here, let me ask. How many people do you think Hooktail's gobbled? All time, I mean. I mean, she recently lunched on Old Man Scoo two villages over. And Koops, who lives next door, his father went off to battle Hooktail ages ago. He's been a missing person. No, wait, that's not right. A missing Koopa ever since. I like that she has, like, this little worried animation. And she just had this standard happy animation when she said it in the original, and it just made her sound, like, really insensitive. Hey, how many people do you think the dragon's gobbled? Ugh. Anyway. Yay, star piece. Yep. Whack every tree and bush that you see, just in case. You struck first. Alright. Well, first let's go ahead and stun this bad boy. Alright. Now let's tattle. Chicka 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 tron. That's a Koopa Troopa. They've been around forever. Gotta respect longevity. Alright, max HP, blah blah blah. Their shells are hard, but flip them over and their defense drops to zero. And you know how to flip them over, right? Yep, jumps and pow blocks. So get in there and get stomping. Pretty much. The only troublesome thing is having to flip them over. Also, a little weird that this and the first one are the only games where jumping on a Koopa doesn't make it retreat into its shell, and then you can kick it. Alright, level up, baby! First one. I'm gonna mainly be sticking to badge points. I'll probably drop something into FP and maybe HP, but for the most part, it's gonna be BP. Because with badges, you can do anything. If there's something that could be done in this game, there's probably a badge for it. And having as many of those as possible is only a good thing. Eh? What's this? Okay, can I block? No? Alright. A scripted fight. This wasn't in the original. Mario, look at the audience. Is this a force tutorial? This is a force tutorial. Not just emotionally. Yeah, I skipped this part and, because Frankly was supposed to teach us this, and... Okay, well... Okay, now I'm being forced to attack with a hammer, even though that's not optimal? Okay... This is just weird. Okay, Okay, well, they didn't explain this in the game. About dropping the backdrop, but I don't know. Oh, this is weird. Alright, Super Guard. I think it's a little easier. But it has to be like on the frame windows when they're touching Mario. I don't know. That's weird that they forced the tutorial on you later on. Kind of reminds me of Superstar Saga, with that early on tutorial, because they don't give you a choice, they pretend to, but then you have to progress right past, and they're like, yeah, I'm gonna tell you anyway, because Bowser would get mad. But yeah, you do stylish. Basically, that star meter. How it works is, I get, a special move. I got a move right now called Sweet Treat. It basically heals you up. But it requires that meter to use. And doing successful action commands and, doing stylish can fill up the meter. And if you do stylish and, nail those commands, then it gets even better. So, yeah. This is how it rolls. Alright, should be ready. But seriously... This almost looks like some kind of statue. What if you give it a good whack with your hammer? That's weird. Because normally you would check them, they would come off and stuff, but now I gotta, hit it with my hammer. And I guess it gives the hammer more to do, but... It's really more of an origami and color splash thing. Whacking things. Alright, bold cliffs. That's a bald cleft. Basically a rock monster with a sharp, craggy face. This is kind of mean, but bald guys really just don't do it for me. Okay, I didn't need to know that. Fire doesn't even hurt it. Alright. Well, luckily I got all these pal blocks, and the game has been very generous so far. Bap. And they're dead.
So yeah, as long as you explore, the game will give you what you need.
Luckily, as a kid, these guys never stumped me, because I always used Tattle. And she basically just says, yeah, use an item. And, you know, power blocks are everywhere. Come here, you.
Face of Mario's mighty boots!
Doing pretty good today so far. How are you guys? Feel free to let me know if you're enjoying the series so far. And let me know if you guys have gotten the game yet. I mean, I'm having a blast. I highly recommend getting the game. There's no reason not to at this point. Because the original, yeah, it's gone up in price. I'm trying to take somewhat decent care of my copy, because who knows, it might be worth something someday, though maybe not as much now, because we have this remake, but I'm glad that more people get to experience this, so hopefully they finally go back to this style. I really want them to, like, bring back the traditional game combat. Because while Origami King isn't a bad game, its combat is just... ugh. I did not like the ring puzzles. It just didn't do it for me. I mean, it's better than Color Splash and such in some ways, but in others, it just doesn't feel rewarding. And I just want to keep going to the next scenario and just get through the combat with as little trouble as possible, because it's mostly just so annoying. The boss battles were fine, but eh. But this kind of makes me wonder if they'll do a Super Paper Mario remake. Doing that with some modern controls would be interesting. A lot of motion controls, mainly the pointer for tippy stuff. Ugh. Jeez, do not first strike these guys. Ooh. The crab guys? You could first strike them.
Luigi's in the audience! Hi, bro! Hey, everybody, it's Luigi!
Luigi number one.
It's nice to see him supporting Mario. That's a bristle. They're covered in spikes. They're so prickly.
Okay, defense is 4, and they're impervious to fire.
Even trying to get close enough to whack it with a hammer is dangerous. Seriously, its spikes will totally pop out. But since you can't jump on it or use your hammer, you better use an item.
Well, game's been telegraphing to use pow blocks, so here we go. Pow block.
Bam. Just so nice of Luigi to come out and support his brother.
We'll see later on. Luigi's not just here in the audience. He's doing something else. I don't think it's gonna be much different than what he did in the GameCube version, but I'm looking forward to it. We'll definitely have to check in with it.
Bap. 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 Bap you with my hammer.
Ooh. Ooh! I don't even feel bad about, like, getting into battles too much, because it's just so fun. I mean, why wouldn't I want to play this? I'm rewarded with money and experience points, and it's just fun, the rhythm. It's just a rewarding experience, and also the music is just great. Oh yeah, while I'm thinking of it, if you guys like Paper Mario, which I hope you do if you're watching this video, definitely check out the Paperverse community. It's a community of event game developers that really love the Paper Mario series, and they make projects inspired by them. You might know of stuff like Born of Bread, which recently came out last year. Pretty good game. I still need to go back and finish it, but very beautiful game. And Bug Fables, which was a great success. I love that game. It's probably one of my favorite Paper Mario likes of all time. Like, seriously, it like takes the gameplay from here in Thousand Year Door and expands on it and does like its own thing, and it's just wonderful. Highly recommend it. It's on Switch right now, so if you like Thousand Year Door, or if you just want to try something that's not Mario, definitely check that out and check out the Paperverse community. There are so many different projects, and it's not just limited to like Paper Mario or like paper in general. It's just anything like slightly related or inspired by it. Oh yeah, HPFB. I'll include like a link in the description to their stuff, in the description. So definitely check out Paperverse. They got like this cute little mascot named Pepper. It's really great. This is Schwonk Fortress. Suspicious statue. I'm pretty sure it's a thwomp bust. Hey, I just remembered something I read about this place in a book. Whenever the villagers were confronted with a monster, they'd hide in this fortress. Guess there's a little bit of history everywhere you look, huh, Mario? Oh. Oh wow, he has the thwomp voice. You're the first contestants I've seen in a while. You must want the Sun and Moon Stones, and if that's the case, then you must compete against me. If you win, I'll let you through to where the stones rest. However, if you lose, you will suffer a terrible fate. By terrible, I mean awful. So, what do you want to do? I'll take you on. I thought I had to fight this guy the first time I got here. You're in for it now. Ooh. Oh. Oh, I like the transition even more in this version. Oh, and they're like mystified. That didn't happen in the original. They just kind of accepted it at face value. Hey, hey, it's that time again. Welcome everyone to the 65th Trivia Quiz Off. Now there's a little in-joke for you, because in Paper Mario 64, Peach would get into a quiz and it was like the 64th. And from here on, anytime there's like some sort of quiz in the Paper Mario games, they kind of like build off of the number. I think they stopped doing like the number thing with Sticker Star, which bleh. But I think they got up to like 67th by the time of Super, which was really great. If you correctly answer 5 of the following questions, you'll win, but get 3 wrong and you'll suffer. Alright, what's hidden in Schwonk Fortress? You know, Pickle Stone, I think in Japanese, it was Luigi's underpants. I wish they kept that for, like, this redone translation. Arg, that's correct. That question was too easy, but it only gets harder from here. Much harder. So prepare yourself. On to question 2. What do one mushroom... Okay. They changed this question a little bit. 12 coins, yeah. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. It's normally the third answer for that one. That's correct. The question was too easy, but it only gets harder from here. Much harder. So prepare yourself. Moving on, question 3. What is the name of the mayor of Petalburg? Croup. Is that your real answer? Are you sure? Arg, that's correct. Okay. We're not done yet, folks. Question 4. Tell me now, where is the crystal star? Hooktail Castle, is that your... Yes. Right again. Tell me you didn't just get your 4th right answer. It can't be true. That's it. I'm making the rest of these near impossible. Get ready for brain pain. Are you ready for the diabolical question 5? what can one get from Rogueport? How can one get from Rogueport to Bellamo's?
Go through a pipe, race in a cart. I like how they make that joke answer, but the carts don't actually come into play until, like, Color Splash with Luigi.
Alright, I win.
Yes! Welcome!
Oh, nice playing around with the angles.
So very angry! I can't believe I lost. Guess I have to let you through, stupid rules.
Wow. Very interesting looking thwomp. I like how they made him look in this one. It's very, very neat. Oh. Schwank Fortress sublevel.
Oh yeah, multi-bounce baby!
Definitely putting that on. Eh, might as well put on Close Call. Not gonna bother with nostalgic tunes, cause I wanna hear the new music. Alright.
Bam. Bam.
I'll tell these guys later. And there's a better opportunity. Alright, getting the guard down. I know that one's tricky. While the 30 FPS doesn't bother me, they did slow down, like, the inputs and, like, some of these animations and such. So it feels like it takes a little too long to get back into the action. I don't know. Oh, that's new. Huh. I don't think they have these. Oh, free fire flower. I'll take it. Oh, they made it look a little more decrepit. Interesting. Mystical stones shaped like the sun. Alright, here we go. Now we can tattle and find out what these things are. Alright, swap. Fuzzies. You know, for the longest time I thought they originated in this game, but no. Fuzzies actually come from Super Mario World, where they would ride on rails. Completely impervious. That's a fuzzy. What a hyper little guy, huh? Cut back on the caffeine. Max HP is 3, attack is 1, and defense is 0. Those things who suck up your HP and use it to replenish their own. Isn't that the worst? I mean, ew, doesn't that just sound totally gross? Anyway, looks like you need to use the guard action band when they release you. Alright, blah, blah, blah. These things really suck. HP. very nice. But yeah, they have 3 HP, so it's just easy to take them out with fire flowers. I wouldn't waste it on just 2 of them, but when there's like 3 or more, good idea to just take them out that way. Ooh, coins! They didn't give me coins in the original. Not the forced ones, anyway. Oh, you gonna come for me? Come for me, bad boy?
Oh, messed that up.
Alright.
Uh-oh, that guy's got a sleepy sheep. You're going down, sucker. HP sucker, that is.
Only within this past year or so, I think I've learned Goombella's stylish command for that, so... Really proud of it. Ah. Messed up the timing. Oh well.
Thing is, it's just annoying. Because they're not even replenishing their own HP at that point, they're just wasting mine. Magic, man, I guess it's fine.
There we go. I just wonder if, like, the lower frame rate will, like, make it easier to do blocks and such. Just something
thinking about.
Oh yeah, but it's more about Paperverse. My good friend Luke, also known as Lucas Max Dream, definitely check him out. His game project, Vivid. What was he calling it now? Vivid Spirit? Yeah, I think that's what the name we decided on. But yeah, it's what we call a paper Kirbyvania kind of game. Because, let's see how it works is, it has that paper and arts and crafts kind of art style. So it's all like pretty much hand drawn and everything. But, it's kind of like a Kirby game it's a platformer and it's got different weapons and abilities and such, and there's also some Metroidvania in there. But yeah, it's a project he's been working on for many years. It was successfully kickstarted. We're very proud of that. And while he's been taking a break from it for a while, it's progressing, and he's slowly sharing some more of it. And so I just wanted to plug my good friend Luke. So if you like paper style games and just in indie games and such, definitely keep an eye out. Because I think we still have some videos up here on the channel. Did some trailers and such for them. I'm just really, really happy for him. Just hope things are going well, Luke. Ooh, second level up! Hope he's enjoying the game. We bonded over when Color Splash was announced, and that's kind of how I met him. We wanted to make a better game than Color Splash. Basically what all those other folks in the Paperverse community were doing. But even before that. Alright, let's see. Yep, there's a new box here, too. It's a mushroom, though. Oh, well, I'll take it. Got the Moonstone! Pokemon Sun and Moon for the Nintendo Sandwich! Ooh. Yeah. Yeah, let's save some headache. Burn, baby, burn! Easy peasy lemon squeezy. But yeah, definitely check out Paperverse. There's a Paperverse Discord. I think I'm on there, though. Like I said, I haven't been on Discord much myself. I've just been busy with life and making these videos. Oh, what was that expression mark? New York. Hey, you suspicious types, this is our place, and coming here is rude, rude, rude. Sorry, suckers, if you want a warm welcome, too bad. Now I lunch on your head. Now I lunch on your head. Now that is a line. Alright. Can't flee this fight. Bam. 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 Gotta scan them rare enemies. Mini-bosses. That's a gold fuzzy. Whoa, those are super rare. I'm serious. Wow. Alright. Oh, but hey, even though it's a fuzzy, it won't suck up your HP, which is nice. I have to wonder, though, how does this thing hide? Look at it. It's so gaudy. Oh, nope, nope. Power smash, baby. Woohoo! Alright. Me oof, hey ow, you chumps are tougher than you look, but I'm not through yet, everyone. Get 'em! Ooh.
Okay. Well, hopefully I can survive.
Oof.
did take a hit.
Oof. Yep. Oh, hey.
Doesn't show me the HP of them.
I can tell the fuzzy board. That's new. It just automatically showed it to me in the original. There wasn't a separate thing for them. It's a fuzzy horde. Look at them all. What a mob scene. The fuzz is a buzz. Max HP is 20. Jeez. Fuzzy's says here not to freak out. Also says if you use good timing to defend, you won't take much damage. I think it might just be faster to whip the ringleader, though, you know?
Definitely.
Get some extra damage. There we go. Dang. So good. All right. Wipe them out. Dang, got 20 star points for that. Good deal.
You got me.
Alright. Well, we're all done there. Now time to head back up top. Probably just cut back. Oh. Sounds like you got an email, Mario.
Oh, okay.
You should check it out. Okay.
So check your email under Mailbox SP in the menu if you want. Some folks just like menus, you know?
Hello, Mario. Working hard? Professor Frankly here in e-form. It's highly likely you'll receive emails like this one while you're on your journey, so check your mail often. Actually, I have nothing more to say than that. I just hope all goes well, and I look forward to getting more information on those crystal stars. Professor Frankly.
Hey, what's shaking? I gotta say, I've been playing a lot of Nintendo 64 games recently. You know the N64, right? Well, the game I play the most on it is Paper Mario. There's this girl in the game, Bo, who's pretty much the cutest boo of all time.
You got good taste, kid. You got good taste in games.
I don't know if you know, but there's an odd-shaped boulder west of the village. Figure it must be a relic of a long-lost civilization. Sounds cool, right?
excuse me.
Oh, hey.
It's Mario, right? Look, See, the thing is, I've been waiting here in the hopes of getting to speak with you. See, I was wondering, would you...
Oh, please take me with you to fight Hooktail, please, I'm begging you.
Sorry about that. See, my dad, he went off to battle Hooktail long ago, but he never came back. I miss him, of course. I miss him badly. But this isn't just about avenging my dad. Well, no, that's not true. Revenge is a part of it, I guess. A big part. But the truth is, I want to finish what Dad started. For his sake. For everyone's sake. Man, this is embarrassing. See, everyone always says I'm a crybaby, a weakling. But if I can defeat Hooktail, well, I won't be those things. I'll be strong like my dad.
Mario's understanding nod, I love it. I know it'll be dangerous, but I still want to go. Please, Mario.
Sure, come along.
For real? No kidding, yes, thank you so much. You won't regret this.
Yep.
Koops has joined the party. Alright.
Yeah, I know. Forced tutorials again. Alright, well, I guess some people need that. Yeah, Koop.
moves is super handy. Alright. Yeah, I've mastered them. Okay, power shell. Alright, yep. Ooh. Okay, Mario, let's get going. Koops. Oh, golly, hi, Koopy-Koo, did you overhear all that? Well, part of it, Koops, I thought I heard you say you're off to fight Hooktail. But you're joking, right? I mean, you're not exactly a powerhouse. She'll eat you up. I know, Koopy-Koo, but I want to be tougher, for you. No, Koops, you don't. I mean, going off to some dangerous place, it's stupid. So what if you're timid and sort of a crybaby? I don't care about all that. I just want you to be you, so don't go. Sorry, I've made up my mind. I'll be fine. After all, I'm traveling with Mario and... Fine, ignore me! Stubborn Koopa. I'm sorry, Koopy-Koo. I swear to you, I will come back to you a stronger Koopa. Well, Mario, that's that, I guess. No turning back. Hooktail's castle awaits.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Koops didn't even get to say that Mario's the man. Huh. What the? Hello, Mario. Still working hard? Professor Frankly here in E-form again. I do have more to say, as it turns out. Goombella was eager to join your side, and she won't be the last. Okay. And the partner ring. Alright, first... That noble noggin of yours, okay. Well, that's pretty interesting. Yep, handy. Yeah, let's go ahead and put it into use. Ooh. Yeah, you gotta think about the formation. Because I could go ahead and hammer that guy, but then Koops wouldn't be able to do anything. Whew. Alright. That's pretty much how Koops works. Time to head back to the castle. I'm gonna go raid us a castle. Oh, wait, while I'm here. Farming those forever. But here we go. Get a badge! Nope. You all don't give me enough star points anymore. Do not need you. Thank you. Come again. Alright, the sunstone is in place. And the moonstone is in place. Huh. Ah, ye old writing. Well, hold on, I want to check some. Huh, these would. Oh, okay. Okay, Koops. There's going to be so much more new dialogue. That's nice. Here beginneth the path to dread Hooktail Castle. Weaklings retreateth. Ye who seeketh to proceed, a power of two must hitteth both switches simultaneously. Addendum. This challenge is easiest peasieth if ye use the skill of a Petalburg Koopa. They changed the dialogue on there too. If ye be a Petalburg Koopa, rejoice. Should make it a snap. Alright. And there it goes. I like that this is a thing that they kept, was going into the background. They kept this around for Super Paper Mario. It's just nice. Nice little funny thing. Alright, pop a save, hop up here. Alright, don't need to be up there just yet. Gonna go get something. Oh, wow. Hooktail Castle. Oh man, Hooktail Castle. The stories were all true. This place is terrifying. Alright, hop down here. Didn't know about this for a number of years, but... Yay, HP Plus badge. Thank you. Well, did it on purpose. Speed strats. Totally did it on purpose. You didn't see that. Alrighty, ready. Turn into a plane. Whee! And in we go. Alright, first strike. Oof. That wasn't anything special. Take this guy out. Bam. Go back down. Take a nap. That's a Koopa Paratroopa. Well, it's basically a Koopa Troopa with wings. Alright. I kind of hate that this guy gets to fly. Of course you can stomp on him and he'll plunge down and be a plain Koopa Troopa. Yeah, do that and he's ours. Stomp again to flip him and his arms and legs are useless. Oops, that's not true. Looks like he can still wiggle them around a bit. Wow. I like that these wild Koopa Troopas have, like, sunglasses and, like, armbands and stuff. Just kind of shows that they're not friendly and not exactly associated with Bowser either. It's just mainly just, like, green Koopa Troopas are the peace-loving ones. And red Troopas are the enemies. I don't know. I just like Paper Mario. It makes me happy. Oh yeah, baby, Power Bound. Oh no. These bones, they remind me of my father. There's no doubt about it, it's my father. Dad! Wait, what's this? My father's clutching some kind of letter, or at least his... bones are. So, what should I do? Should I read it?
Yeah, read it. Go ahead. I want to see the script change.
Okay, I can do this. I'll read it. Ahem. I came to this castle to destroy Hooktail, but I am stuck and could go no further. So in this letter, I shall note Hooktail's weaknesses for those who follow. The dread Hooktail cannot tolerate croaking creatures that begin with Fraw, F, and end with Rog. I hear that something related to Hooktail's weakness is hidden somewhere in this castle. If one is to have any hope of defeating Hooktail, one must first find whatever that thing is. One last thing. If faced with ultimate doom, the fiend will surely use any trick to save herself. Alas, I do not have the strength to continue writing. Already mist veils my eyes. My last words go to my son, Colorado. I love you and I'm proud of who you've become. Huh? My son, Colorado? Not Coops? Oops. Yeah, I guess this isn't my father after all. But if this isn't my father, I wonder if that pile of bones over there is my dad.
Yeah, that's Colorado's dad from Paper Mario 64, the famous archaeologist. Bit of a doof, really.
Yeah, I don't want that.
You clearly don't value your lives much if you've come to this castle to disturb us. You will go no farther, and from this moment on, you'll be nothing but bones.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Ow, watch it, Pushy. What's with these numbskulls? They're shoving me around. What should we do?
Back off, buddy. Alright, here we go.
Luigi! Luigi's in the fight. What the hell?
That's a red bone. It's a little too red, I think. No fashion sense, you know? Alright. Unlike your average dull bones, even if you pound it to 0 HP and it crumbles, it totally might revive like a zombie. My advice is to get rid of all the dull bones, then attack the red bones. Oh, one more thing. Once its friends start to fall, it may create some more.
Eh. Just wanted to see that. What the appeal command looked like. And yeah, I just wanted to get off another tattle before I just take them all out.
Okay, go ahead. That's a dull bone, sort of a skeleton thing. It was a Koopa Troopa once. Okay. These creep throws bones to attack and they build reinforcements too. Attacks that can strike multiple dull bones at once are the most effective. Alright, here we go. Use an item. Bye-bye, bone guys.
Dang. Dang, these guys hit hard.
Okay, let's see. Alright. Oh, I'm almost up to a level up. Oof. Took a lot of beating there. Get out of here. Get out of here.
Super guard.
Eat hammer!
Oh, dang. Well, that was easy. What? Ooh. There we go.
I still haven't used a single special move. I will be after this chapter, though.
Alright, gimme. Shine Sprite! Shine Git! Alright, come on. Gonna take you out. Who's gonna take you out? I'm gonna take you out. Who's gonna take you out? Coop's gonna take you out. Whew! Alright, gotta do some puzzling. Actually, I'll do even more puzzling, because I gotta do this. Some light platforming, do a whack-up, and boop! Secret! It's a secret. Okay. Let's whack that to get down. Okay, hold on to that. Now we're gonna do it again. And there we go. Do another little whack and flip the stairs.
Hey, at least it's a little faster.
Okay. Give me that key. Thanks, Coops. Now go whack at that switch. Flip. Hop, hop, hip, hop. And get the red key. Alright, here we go. Might as well bop the save block. Alright, here we go. Just slap that. And skadoosh. Okay, gonna come on in here. Oof, just as oppressive as the original. Ech. Hate that I have to come back here. Alright, black key. Oh! Mario, look at that. Oh, no. I don't like the look of this. Come on, run. Oh, dear.
Oh, dead end. Well, isn't this stressful?
Run! Run, plumber boy, run! You must run, Mario. Run! Whoo! Anyway. He doesn't say, ooh, gotta shake it off and everything. Interesting. Oh, dang! Hey, guess! It's been a long time since anyone came here. A real long time. Huh? You heard me? Wow. Wait a sec. If you can hear my voice, you must be some legendary hero or something. Oh yes, I am a pretty legendary. Or not. To be honest, I'm sure anyone with ears can hear me. But it sure is fun zinging people with the whole legendary hero bit. Hey, but seriously folks, I was wondering if you could let me out of this chest. I've been locked in here so long I'm starting to cramp up like you wouldn't believe. All you have to do is find the key and let me out. Easy.
What do you mean? You think you'll be cursed if you open the box? Ridiculous. Who would do that, really? Wade in a box and curse folks? A real slime ball, that's who. But I'm not a real slime ball, and I would not do no such thing. But that should be obvious. Look, if you help me out, maybe I'll help you out. You know, a little I scratch your back, you scratch mine, except in reverse order. Of course, you don't have to really if you don't want to. Finding a key like this is hard. Hang on, what's this? You already found the key? Unbelievable. Here we go.
Wee!
Fools! Mario's just, like, exasperated. Why only the most idiotic pudding-brained dolt would fall for a scheme like that? The castle's traps prevent anyone who's entered this place from ever leaving it. No matter which path you take, you're fated to waste away to a slow, painful end. But wait, there's more to this great deal. I'll throw in a free curse, no charge. Oogly googly boo.
Wee-hee.
Now you're cursed, doofus. It serves you right. This curse is more cursedly curse-worthy than any curse that's ever cursed you. For this curse makes you like a piece of paper when you press and hold ZR.
Wee-hee.
What a curse. Who curses like me? No one. Now I shall show you just how frightful a curse it is. Just look at yourself. How embarrassing for you. You'll be all papery thin while you press ZR. You'll try to jump or move and you'll probably just wobble there. Do you understand what this curse means for you? I got it. Then farewell, you dumbbells.
Whee!
Okay. And now I can access the Pit of 100 Trials if I wanted to. Change the sound effects of Mario's attacks to sound froggy. Used to be crickets in the original. Wonder why they changed it. Oh, yeah, wrong. Bang, bang. Here we go. Yeah, why not? Alright. Interesting enough. Save. Right, there we go. Oops. Okay, I guess I gotta go pick it up. Nice to see that they made the keys color-coded this time. It's an interesting change. Okay, Koops. I thought you were locked up in there forever. Alright, here we go. Okay. I'll go ahead. Got plenty. And bam. Wow. Okay. And bam. Okay. Yep, that's too far. So we just gotta hop out here. There we go. Star piece. Lovely, lovely star piece. Gonna get my quick change badge. Yeah, open the door. And away we go. Nope, you ain't getting me. You ain't getting me. Wait, how far am I? Yeesh. Okay, I'm just going to do that. I like how they zoomed out the camera for this room. Very nice. Very nice. Oh. Eat it. Eat it, you undead bag of bones. Oop, oop.
You do the hammer.
Alright. Just gonna hop down here and get myself a life shroom. Yay! Super interesting. Instead of like one-up shrooms, they're life shrooms, and what would be a one-up mushroom is like an ultra shroom. Paper Mario's weird like that.
Huh? Oh my. Who's this handsome piece of cheese? I can't believe there are other thieves here besides me. How very strange. Hey, who are you? Me? Why, I'm Miss Mouse, the globe-trotting thief. Heard of me, sweetie? I heard there are rare and valuable badges here in this castle. That's why I'm here. But the real question is, why are people like you roaming in such a rundown place?
Well, you see, we're here to beat Hooktail and get the, Crystal Star. So, don't think we'll let you get the Crystal Star first, no matter how cute you are.
Crystal Star, you say? I didn't know a thing like that was hidden in this castle. Sounds intriguing. Perhaps I just heard something you didn't want me hearing?
Darn.
Oh, but that's okay. I mean, you were looking for this Crystal Star first. I already found the badge I was after, so I'll let you get your Crystal Star.
Hey, what's that supposed to mean?
I means I must say bye-bye for now, Mr. Cutie. I know, it's sad. We just met and already it's time to say farewell. Alas.
Oh my, you're so bold. Is that legal?
Oh, I almost forgot. I have a little secret to share with you. Somewhere in this castle is a badge that'll help you best Hooktail, or so I've heard. I don't know what kind of badge it is. Maybe you found it already, maybe not. If you're gonna fight Hooktail, I'd recommend finding that badge first. Well, take care, handsome mustache man. Let's get together again real soon.
I like how sassy the animations are. I wonder what her story is. I bet it's an interesting one, full of romance. Oh, poor Koops has it bad. Dude, you're already in a relationship. Don't. Trust me. Just don't.
Yay, yellow castle key! Regular mushroom! Now what's in here? Honey syrup, okay.
What's my gear looking like? Alright, 12 out of 15, alright. Might have to start dropping soon. But we are getting close.
Get out of here.
Alright, open the door. And away we go. Go. All right, here we go. All right. Okay, go get it for me, Koops, because I do not want to fall off like you. Hey, get up, my boy. Alright. Let's go ahead and grab that. And we got the blue key. I'm not going to go for that, that badge. We can get it much later. I don't think it's really all that good to begin with. It's like a thing that, like, defends partners if they're in danger or something. Okay, here we go. Sounds like Hooktail has the crystal star. Let's keep moving. Aw, oh, dang it. She talks out of the pocket. Wow. Oh. Oh, that's cool. That is so cool. Alright, okay. Okay. Doop. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at our badges. Oh, that's all I got. I pretty much equipped everything I can. So, I guess it's time. Let's do this. Who dares approach me? Oh. 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 Oh, wow. I didn't expect more to come to steal the treasure I protect. That was foolish, I fear. Do you really think you can beat me? But you're so small, and you don't appear tasty. I suppose you might make a good snack. After gnawing on the bottoms of your feet, I'll saute you to crispy goodness and gobble you down head first. Doesn't talk about making a sauce out of us. Also, the original just talked about the strange garbed one. It wasn't clear if they meant Miss Mouse or somebody else. Snack time, little appetizers. But which one of you morsels should I taste first? Alright. Goombella. Tattle. Tattletale, tattletale. That's Hooktail. Max HP is 20, attack is 5, defense is 1. She'll stomp and munch on you when she has a more dragonish attack, stinky fire breath. She's tricky, especially when she's losing, and she'll try to fool you into being merciful. Oh yeah, and one more thing. She hates things that start with F and end with Rog. Supposedly, there's something related to that somewhere in this castle. Did we find it? Heck yeah, we did. Ugh, that awful sound. It sounds like a frog. How did you know? I really got bad food poisoning once when I ate a frog. I hate them. Oh, fight it, Hooky. Just hearing the sound of them makes me feel woozy. And now that defense has dropped to 0. Oh dear. Oh, I got roasted. Okay. Swap partner. Alright. Let's do Power Smash. Ooh, look how stylish I am. Oh, must not gag so very woozy. Oof. Poor Koops. Alright, you got this, man. Alright, let's see. Just checking my options. Ooh, that was poor. Oh, it didn't repel. I mean, I took no damage, but... Ooh, determined Koops. Refill that flower power. Now let's try this again. Ooh, I'm not doing great. Oof. this timing down. I got to, if I'm gonna break this game. Ooh, that's not good. Alright, well. And a stomper. But you can't get through my shell defense. Alright, time to finish off. Do what my dad couldn't. Oh, wait, hold up a minute. I give up. Please, I won't be so bad anymore, I promise. In fact, I'm sorry for everything. Yeah. To prove it, I'll give you 10,000 coins. What do you say? Can you forgive me? Keep your coins, fiend. What? You must be joking. You don't need any coins? Then how about the lovely, rare, extra special badge I have? I'll give you that. It's one of a kind, and it's yours for a limited time only. Will you take it? Keep it, you monster. Really? Well, I suppose I could apologize by letting you smell the bottoms of my feet. So, care to take a whiff of the rich yet delicate scent of my world-renowned feet? One-time offer. Maybe just a quick sip. That's disgusting! You aren't a very trusting fellow, are you? It's important to be able to trust someone, you know? I guess I'd better. Oh no. Oh. She ate the toads! Why? This is toad abuse! Toads have rights! That's just not right. Now my strength has returned to me. I've had enough of this. Let's finish this gal off fast, Mario. Free the toads! Why do I always have to feel so faint every time I hear a frog? Get 'em, Koops! Bingo time! And no bingo. What would it matter anyway? There's no audience anymore. Alright, come on, Koops. You can do it. He did it. How? Why? There's still so much I wanted to do with my life. So many meals. Dang. Clear bonus. 30 star points. Wow. Dang. Mario killed a dragon. Wow, we actually pulled it off, Mario! Now all we have to do is find that crystal star thing you're looking for, Mario. Oh, that's nasty. Yeah! I'm out, I'm finally out! Whoa, it can't be. Eh? Dad? Daddy? Well, if it isn't Koops. Hey, son, you've gotten so big since I saw you last. Well, yeah, I guess I have, but who cares, Dad? I mean, golly, what happened to you? Where have you been all this time? Well, I came here a while back to deal with Hooktail, and all was well and good. But just before my finishing blow, she used the smell from her feet to stun me, then gobbled me down whole. He said yes to the smell of the feet. Oh, that's new. He just said that Hooktail tricked him. I've been hiding in my shell for the 10 years since then, inside Hooktail's belly. And boy, was it nasty. Yuck. I'm so glad to finally get out.
Honestly, Dad, everyone's been so worried about you this whole time.
Oh, sorry, son, but I'm okay. That's good, right? We're together now, right?
Hey, speaking of which, what are you all doing here anyway?
Oh, come on, Dad. We came here to defeat Hooktail. And Mr. Mario here is looking for a gem called the Crystal Star.
Crystal Star? This wouldn't be what you're talking about, would it?
Ooh, they're so pretty now.
What's that?
I found it down there in Hooktail's belly. Nice, huh? I was gonna keep it as a souvenir. But if this is the thing you've been looking for, you can have it.
Come now, I won't take no for an answer. You're Koops's friend, right? Please take it.
Here we go.
Oh. Oh. That HD rumble. Oh, that felt good.
You guys gotta play this. That felt good.
You got a crystal star.
Alright, Earth Tremor, baby!
Alright!
Oh, the screen looks so pretty.
Oh.
Cleared? Weird. Only it says chapter end.
Using the magical map they received from Princess Peach, Mario and his friends claimed their first crystal star. With the deadly dragon Hooktail defeated, the citizens of Petalburg would rest easy once again. Koops even reunited with his long-lost father, whom he thought was dead. And yet, despite victory in the castle, Princess Peach's whereabouts were still unknown. Where could she be? Yes, it seems Mario's adventure has only just begun.
Alright. Well, guys, I think I'm gonna call it there for right now. I'll see you guys next time on Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door. Bye.